Hello guys, in this lesson we are going to talk about hypothyroidism. So hypothyroidism is the most common thyroid disorder and one of the most common endocrine disorders in dogs. The primary function of the thyroid gland is to produce active thyroid hormones, T4 and T3. Thyroid hormone production is controlled primarily by negative feedback. The hypothalamus secretes TRH, which stimulates specific anterior pituitary cells to promote synthesis and secretion of TSH. TSH promotes iodide trapping by the thyroid, as well as the synthesis and release of thyroid hormones. And for example, the presence of excess circulating free T3 and T4 produces negative feedback to the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary, decreasing TRH and TSH synthesis and release, and subsequently thyroid hormone production. Thyroid hormones have effects on the heart, are necessary for cholesterol synthesis and metabolism, and are capable of stimulating erythropoiesis, so the production of red blood cells. For that reason, when the thyroid hormones are deficient in case of hypothyroidism, the list of potential abnormalities is extensive. So let's see what happens in the hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism results from decreased production of T4 and T3 and can arise because of an abnormality in any step of the hypothalamic pituitary thyroid gland axis. It can be primary if the underlying lesion is in the thyroid gland itself, secondary if the underlying lesion is in the pituitary gland, tertiary if the lesion is in the hypothalamus. It can also be described as congenital or acquired, depending on the age at which it develops. Congenital hypothyroidism is less common and results from thyroid hypoplasia or aplasia, from an abnormal thyroid gland development, or from a defect in the steps of thyroid hormone synthesis and secretion. It can develop in puppies with mothers that were fed iodine-deficient diet or mothers given various drugs. Acquired hypothyroidism can be central, TRH or TSH deficiency, or primary, T3 or T4 deficiency. The central hypothyroidism is rare, accounting for less than 5% of hypothyroid dogs. It usually results from pituitary neoplasia and surgical hypophysectomy, but it can also result from trauma. On the other hand, acquired primary thyroid disease accounts for the majority of dogs with hypothyroidism. It can result from lymphocytic thyroiditis, a destructive autoimmune process in which there's infiltration of the thyroid gland by lymphocytes, macrophages, and plasma cells, and progressive replacement by connective tissue. It can result from thyroid atrophy, in which there's a degenerative process with gradual replacement of thyroid tissue by adipose and connective tissue. In either case, the cause for these conditions is unclear. Hypothyroidism can occur in dogs of any breeds, but reported breed predispositions include English Setter, Golden Retriever, Rhodesian Ridgeback, Cocker Spaniel, Boxer, Great Dane, Beagle, Schnauzer, and Doberman. It is more common in dogs of 4 to 10 years old, with a mean age of 7 years, and intact males and neutered females may be at increased risk. A decline in the metabolic rate is typical, so metabolic signs are present in about 80% of dogs, such as lethargy, obesity or weight gain, exercise intolerance, and cold intolerance. Thyroid hormones play an important role in the maintenance of hair growth, so dermatological abnormalities appear in up to 80% of hypothyroid dogs. Alopecia, usually in the flanks and thighs, and failure to regrow hair after clipping. This is an endocrine alopecia because dogs don't have pruritus, they don't scratch themselves, it is bilateral and symmetric, and usually spares the head and extremities. Dry, poor quality coat with hair thinning and dry skin with scales. Skin hyperpigmentation, pyoderma if there are secondary bacterial infections, and in these cases dogs have pruritus, so but this only happens in less than 10% of the dogs, otitis and seborrhea. Other clinical signs that may be present include various neuropathies such as facial nerve paralysis, laryngeal paralysis, megaesophagus, peripheral vestibular disease, and lower motor neuron dysfunction, central vestibular disease, but is rare, myxedema coma is a rare syndrome, and it is the extreme expression of severe hypothyroidism. The course can develop rapidly, lethargy progresses to stupor and then coma. Subclinical myopathy that may cause gait abnormalities, weakness, and exercise intolerance, and it can be difficult to distinguish from neuropathies. Lipid corneal dystrophy, also not common, and is caused by hyperlipidemia. Decreased tear production has also been reported in hypothyroid dogs, and it could exacerbate other underlying ocular pathologies. Bradycardia, since thyroid hormones have a positive nootropic and chronotropic effects on the heart, which improves the function and responsiveness of the heart. Parturient problems. In an experiment, hypothyroidism in bitches resulted in prolonged parturition and reduced pup survival. Decreased fertility. In more chronic hypothyroidism, there's evidence of reduced fertility, increased peripartum mortality, and lower birth weights. Disproportionate dwarfism that you can see here in this image. Dogs with congenital hypothyroidism have disproportionate dwarfism. They appear normal at birth, but signs usually become evident by about 8 weeks of age. They have disproportionately white skulls, macroglossia, so a bigger than usual tongue, delayed dental eruption, and a square trunk and short limbs. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. And if you want me to do a video explaining the methods to diagnose hypothyroidism in dogs, all those endocrine tests, and also the treatment, please like this video and subscribe. Thank you.